Hi everybody and welcome to this Bitwig Studio Basics episode 14. Today we will look at live looping within Bitwig, and what's so good about live looping is that you can continue and work on your arrangement. You can add audio tracks and MIDI tracks without ever stopping your performance. So let's first look at a simple example, and then we will dive in and see exactly how you set up live looping in Bitwig Studio. My name is Mattias and let's take the tour. Okay, so let's now see how we can set up live looping here in Bitwig Studio. First, we need to make sure that we're in the clip launcher view. We can press tab to jump between the arrangement and the clip launcher. Then we go up here to the play menu. And here we have the settings for our clip launching. And we can set a post recording action. So this basically says that after 8 bars, we will record in 8 bars, it will perform this action, which is play a recorded clip. We can also change this to stop, return to last clip, return to arrangement, or play a random clip. But I usually have this at play recorded. Then we have the default launch quantization, set it to 1 bar, that's okay. A pre-roll of 1 bar is okay if you want to have a metronome before you start the recording. Now when we have the clip launcher looper set up, we can just launch this record button on this piano track, and we will have 4 beats of pre-rolled metronome, and then we will start to record our 8-bar piano, and after that it will start to loop this section. So now you see that we have our 8-bar loop and it's looping this piano. Let's go ahead here and add maybe some kick. So with the live looper you can basically just continue and add to your track without ever stopping your arrangement, and I think it's a really great way of sketching out and building up your tracks. Okay, so if you have any questions on live looping or Bitwig Studio in general, you can write them in the comment section below. Yeah, so in conclusion, I think Bitwig Studio is an excellent tool for live looping. We also have some additional options for programming clip launching, so we could basically set up different options after this clip has been played. So we could play a random clip, play previous next, or round robin, etc. So yeah, I did another video on clip launching, so if you want to see a more extensive, in-depth video on programming clip launching, you can look at the description or up here. Okay, so if you want to see more live looping in action, you can check out my previous video on the Minilog XD, where I was using live looping with the Bitwig Studio extensively during that performance. Yeah, so if you're new, please subscribe to this channel. Don't forget to hit the bell notification so you get the notice when I have new videos online. Thanks for watching today. Thanks to you, and see you in the next video. Bye.